at the toss, he was hilarious at the toss yesterday. And then when he came into the post-match thing, I said to him, listen, do we want to start this conversation? Or because they were chanting Dhoni, Dhoni, like they chant Sachin, Sachin in Mumbai. Yeah. He said, no, once we start talking, they'll stop because they want to hear me. I said, well done, yeah.
That was, he's been around for long too.
Does he strike you as being little more relaxed? I'll tell you two things, changes that I see. One is, when you see him on, actually in flesh and blood, you see that his body structure is different. He's a lot slimmer. And his shoulders and chest is bulked up a lot there. So clearly he's been gymming. But do you see a difference in his approach? Is he talking more freely? He's still stumping as well as ever before.
Yeah, he definitely seems relaxed. And it's natural because when you know, he had a tough year and a half. I mean, it wasn't easy. I mean, had it been anybody else, I think probably would have, you know, put his hands up and gone. Things were not easy. And he wasn't fluent with his game. Now it's come back. The whole game has come back. You're scoring on a regular basis. You missed out. You know, there was a game when it could have, some people could have got affected, you know, immensely differently in Bangalore when he just didn't touch that ball off the last ball, needed one run. So things like that, because everything's going positive now.
Yeah.
He's shown us over the years that he doesn't worry about these things. But an ordinary person would have not been able to recover from that. I mean, what he did before that ball is totally different as well. And that is also what he can do. So I think it's his mental ability that has made what he is. And in the last 6-8 months, 1 year, ever since, you know, we started getting runs for India as well, he's been comfortable playing. And naturally, when you're playing well, what's the difference? When you're not playing well, you're stiff and, you know, worried, negative. When you're doing well, everything starts working for you.
Did you sense a man enjoying himself a lot?
Sorry?
Did you sense that he was starting to enjoy it and sort of...
You know... Normally, you do I didn't know how long yesterday's post-match presentation. I'm told it was 11 minutes. I thought it was 4 or 5 minutes because I was listening to the stories as well. But he's starting to tell stories. And I mean, when was the last time you heard Dhoni say that me and Watson don't chase Imran Tahir? He says, no, he's going to come back anyway, right? He's going to come back anyway. We'll say, well played to him when he comes back. But he also said that Rishabh Pant didn't take off the glove for the run out. He said, when I stole the bye with Ambati Raidu to get back in strike for the last two balls, he said, but Rishabh Pant didn't take out the glove from his hand, and that's what helped us. But what was amazing was the connect between Dhoni and Chennai. I mean, it's something that I've never seen. I've seen it with Tendulkar in Mumbai, but it's true of Tendulkar everywhere he goes. It is just the greatest connect between a player and a city.
Yeah, I think IPL has probably done that with players. And, you know, you can think of Kolkata and Gautam Gambhir at one time when you're playing. I think the connect is with the player. You're playing for them and he's been around from day one. And look at the success that they've had. And Chennai has had greats in the past. We've had great cricketers from there. But I think Dhoni brings in another perspective of also, because people from the south are probably a little different. They've had great cricketers playing for them, but this is something that they've never had. They've never had somebody like this who just...
Remember one more thing. When the first IPL auction was actually held,
yes,
they were the only team who didn't even have a designated
icon player.
Because even Deccan Chargers had an option of taking Lakshman.
Yes.
Lakshman very sportingly to give the team more salary cap said that I'm not going to be. All the other six had icon players, whether it's Shaurav or Yuvraj or a Sachin or Sehwag. They didn't. So they actually said, I had to adopt a player. I have to adopt an icon. But once they've taken it, it's so wonderful, which is the only icon left standing now. Look at the 8 teams. The only icon left standing is an icon who didn't belong to the city he started in. It's so fascinating.
And if you add the only icon who's managed to remain an icon till he's playing, you know, when he's still around next year, you don't know. Every other icon, the last couple of years in the IPL, wasn't an icon for the team or for their, you know, their franchise or for their fans. Somebody else took over. This man has not let anybody else take over.